This head overhanging here. Just do this, Rocker throws his leg straight up on my shoulder. I'm now inviting high law. Okay? And I do this. Try to throw it. Okay? Yes, I've got to watch how you push up. Okay, fishing for triangle, for strangles. While I've got this, wash away quick. Okay? So I'm on here. Up, put it in. I walk my knees in, so my knees are either side his hips. Chopping his leg with my other elbow. As I start to pass here, what he might do is focus on my hip. So I'm trying to block me coming through. What this encourages you most people is you start to, it's as though you're going to force the issue and you start driving against him. If you've got a strong guy with a good post there, it's not going to happen. So what you do is pressure his other leg down, so you start to turn him a little bit. Get high on that arm to the hip. As you collapse in, that arm can be trapped. Feeling that weight is there, I'd use that and I'd turn it through. And I'm already rolling in to expose his back. But it's a way of getting rid of that. Okay? Just turn your hip. You might need to do this with your hips. Remember the shaking things. The bounce that we've got that I keep talking about. If we just kill the position, kill the movement. Okay? Here, lock him up, stop to pass, and close on my hip. Okay, so just come up, even if I don't turn him over, I'll control his arms. I'm in time. He's got to start to create something from here, but his arm is compressed right up against his body, so it's weaker. It's not like he's got me lodged out here. And even if he did drop to that, he dropped and the guy got his arm out. I just do the same again. Okay, we'll get rid of it. Okay, the way you'll clear the arm will go over at a later date when we stop, you know, when we go back over to the side control. Alright, so that's the way you get rid of the arm. So have a little practice of that. Don't be too good for banging your hips into it because the other person can end up with an injured wrist. So the other thing that you can do, so go here. Everything's exactly the same. See how I move in here? I don't do this instead because there's a gap between me and his hips. I want to occupy that space. With this, it is very important, like I was saying to Josh, you need to keep the person's hips down. It isn't all about hugging this leg. And if you treat it that way, the person can probably drive the hips out of the ground. So I've got pressure on his hips. So as I start to turn here, he folds and blocks my hip. Okay? So what I do from there, I'll do this the other way around in a second. I track. I come back the other way. Okay? If you go that way, please. So, all the way through. Occupy the space. Trapping his other leg. Okay? Stopping the pressure in. The leg can be blocked. We have to be conscious. Track this. Yeah, my leg is here. Track. I don't lift my arm off because I'm giving space. I track his leg. I'm going to do this gently back. You can see the stretch that he's giving him. Step over. You can exert massive pressure. Even most flexible people, you can put them through some discomfort with this. Set up the beginning exactly the same. Again, this head's important, this side up. Okay? Remember, if I was doing this as me and Rob were live spot, I'd be doing this, very quick. Okay? At this stage, this person on the back is thinking more about dealing with what's coming than thinking, I'll go for a strangle here. Yeah? Because even in this position, he can start reaching for my collar, it's not getting far. He's not going to pull me in very well from here, I'll just extend my arms a little bit. Because while he's holding me and pulling me in, I can pin his hips. He's got to let go of that to be able to climb his hips. So again, start to come in, block this, start turning, he's got the hips. So I track back to there, step over. See, there's still pressure here, I'm not up here, and that's loose, Rob can move. Here. Yeah? I can keep hold of that until I'm ready.
details of you, the leg that you pinned with your hand,
right.
How you then pinned it with your, feet.
Right here. So, this leg position here, I want to create this barrier so Rob can't just try and throw his leg up and put it on my shoulder. He can't triangle me because my hand will be out. Remember triangle rules, both hands in, both hands out. So, from here, I don't want him lifting his leg, so I want to control that, to use it. So having this, I've got a barrier. I'm closing so he can't hook behind and try and elevate my leg. This was right out here, and I've got no control. Yeah, he'd be using that. Even if it was to put his foot on my knee, push off me. To break my posture. Here, I've still got the same. So I track that to the knee. Pin. So again, I'm taking some of the pressure off. I keep this that way. Okay, elbow's still heavy on his hips. I don't want him moving his hips. And all I do from here is I lean on it, slide this leg through. Now walk my foot over. Stops him disappearing out the back. Let's try and look at popping over to salvage something and attack the back. I can step this. And I've still got pressure. Okay? There's not a lot he can do to stop me coming this way, in all fairness. If you've got enough pressure on here, he's willing you to pass. They want you to pass because it's not nice. So again, I can step through, take the head, up. So I put my knee here to his hip. Pass. So again, I'm looking, waiting. He's going to want to bring his legs in. He's looking at wanting to retrieve some sort of guard. So I control is not the position to be stuck with.